Hello. In first lecture, I have explained what is meant by sequence of objects, then real sequence, bounded sequence, monotone sequences, etc. In this lecture, we'll study the concept of limit of sequence, convergent sequence, divergent sequence, and some result on them. So firstly, we'll define the concept of limit of sequence. So for that, if I take the example, say, 1 by n, which has elements 1, 1 half, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, and so on. If I take second sequence, say, minus 1 raised to n, its elements are minus 1, 1, minus 1, and so on. And if I take, say, n is equal to 1 to infinity. For first sequence, you can observe that all 1 by n lies between 0 and 1. 1 by n goes on decreasing and 1 by n never become negative. So if n is very, very large, if I take n is equal to say 10,000, then 1 by n is 1 upon 10,000. N is equal to 1 crore, then 1 upon 1 crore. N is 100 crore, then 1 upon 100 crore. That numbers are very near to 0. So if n is too large, then 1 by n are very, very near to 0, means you are able to tell that 1 by n is very close to 0 if n is sufficiently large, means I can say that 1 by n approaches towards 0 as n goes on increasing. Means we will say that 0 is limit of 1 by n sequence. For second sequence, minus 1 raised to n, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, and dot dot, etc. For that sequence, your odd places are minus 1, even places are plus 1. Even though if n is too large, you will get terms at odd places to be minus 1 and terms at even places to be 1. So even though n is too large, after that also you are getting 1 and minus 1. So you are unable to say that all SNs are very close to fixed number L, because you are getting some numbers which are exactly 1 and some terms which are exactly minus 1. So for this sequence, even though SN is too large, we cannot find L to which all SNs are very near. So this sequence has no limit. N equal to 1 to infinity. For this sequence, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, etc. As N goes on increasing, your terms Sn is equal to n also goes on increasing, and that cannot become very close to some fixed number L, means this sequence also has no limit. Okay, so roughly, real sequence Sn has limit L if n is very, very large implies Sn's are very near to L. That particular number L, if it is unique, then we say that L is the limit of that real sequence. Now we'll express this in mathematically or in mathematical form. So let definition Sn n is equal to 1 to infinity be real sequence and L belongs to R. Then we say that Sn tends to L by symbolically we write like this. As n tends to infinity, if for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists some positive integer n naught, such that mod of Sn minus L is less than epsilon for any n greater or equal n. For given epsilon means even though my epsilon is too small, if I take epsilon is 1, then I am collecting all those Sns which are near to L at a distance 1 from L. This statement is true for epsilon is equal to 0.00001 also, means that Sns are very near to L. Okay, means even though epsilon is too small, for that epsilon also you'll get some positive integer n naught here, so that after that n naught, all terms of that sequence are filinear to L. In fact, all terms after n naught Sn's are close to L. In this case, we'll say that Sn tends to L. Okay. This is equivalent to Sn belongs to, or L minus epsilon is less than Sn less than L plus epsilon for any n greater equal n naught. Again, this is equivalent to Sn belongs to open interval L minus epsilon to L plus epsilon for every n greater equal n naught. So after n naught, all Sn lies between L minus epsilon to L plus epsilon interval. Okay. So if sequence Sn tends to L as n tends to infinity, then we write limit n tends to infinity of Sn is equal to L. This is definition of limit. Now, what is meant by convergent sequence? So, if the given real sequence has limit instead of real number, then we say that sequence is convergent. So, a real sequence Sn n equal to 1 to infinity is convergent if it has a limit, L belongs to R. Now, our aim is to prove that this L must be unique. Okay. So, first we will take some theory. So, what is the theorem? A real sequence Sn is convergent if it has limit L belongs to R. And then we say that sequence Sn converges to L, has limit L belongs to R. In this case, we say that Sn converges to L. If given sequence has no limit, then that sequence is called as divergent sequence. A real sequence Sn which is not divergent, which is not convergent, is called as divergent sequence. Now, in example, I explained that 1 by n, n equal to 1 to infinity, that goes on decreasing and all terms becomes very close to 0, means that 1 by n converges to 0. I have taken second example, minus 1 raised to n, n equal to 1 to infinity. Even though n is very, very large, you are getting Sn's which takes either 1 or minus value, minus 1 value, means that Sn's are not very close to either 1 or minus 1. Means that sequence is divergent. And last example I have taken, n equal to 1 to infinity, again n goes on increasing, that 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, etc., that numbers goes on increasing. So, that n cannot become very close to particular number L, means it is also divergent sequence. So minus 1 raised to n is also divergent, n equal to 1 to infinity is also divergent. Again, there is difference between these two divergence. Minus 1 raised to n is oscillatory sequence, and n equal to 1 to infinity, as n goes on increasing, n tends to infinity. So divergent sequence is again classified into three classes. divergent sequence diverging to plus infinity, divergent sequence diverging to minus infinity, and divergent sequence which neither diverges to infinity nor diverges to minus infinity is called as oscillatory sequence. Okay, so types: a sequence or divergent sequence Sn n is equal to 1 to infinity diverges to plus infinity if for given m greater than 0 positive real number there exists positive integer n naught such that Sn is greater than m for every n greater or equal n naught. So for any m greater than 0 you will get always some n naught on that. After that n naught all Sns become greater than m. So 1 to dot dot etc. If I take m equal to say 10.25 then I will get n naught is equal to 11. After that all Sns are greater than 10.5. If I take m is equal to 1 lakh I will get n naught to be 1 lakh. If I take say root 101 that is near to 10, okay, so I will get m to be 101 so that Sn is greater than that. So in this way for any positive integer for any positive real number m you can find n naught. Okay, so second one, notation: Sn tends to infinity as n tends to infinity. Second, a divergent sequence, a sequence having no limit, Sn diverges to minus infinity if for any m greater than 0 there exists some positive integer n naught such that Sn is less than minus m for every n greater equal n naught. For this m I am taking minus m which is negative number. And third, a divergent sequence Sn which neither diverges to infinity nor diverges to minus infinity is called as oscillatory sequence. I have taken minus 1 raised to n, n equal to 1 to infinity. Okay. So, what is the example here? For this example, say n square. Okay. Then square root n, etc. So for this sequence divergent minus n square, minus 2n, minus 1, these sequences. For this, if I take minus 1 raised to n, if I take 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and so on, if I take other examples, say 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 3, and so on, this sequence. So this sequence cannot go to plus infinity and can't go to minus infinity also, because for any integer n, After that positive integer n, also you will get some terms which are positive, some terms are negative. So for a particular positive number m greater than 0, you cannot get essence greater than that m or essence less than minus m, because after any n greater equal to m naught, you are getting positive, negative real numbers in that sequence, and that's why this sequence is also oscillatory. Okay, so this is the example for that. Here I have given notation sn tends to infinity as n tends to infinity for divergent sequence diverging to infinity for on same line sn tends to minus infinity as n tends to minus infinity for sequence which diverges to minus infinity. Okay. Now our aim is to prove that if the given sequence is convergent, then it has unique limit. Very important result. Any convergent sequence cannot converge to different two limits. Any convergent sequence has unique limit. You have also proved this result in limit of real function chapter. If the given function fx has limit as extending to a, then that fx has unique limit. Okay. Observe the difference between two proofs where that two differs. We are going to prove both results on same line. There is very slight change. Again, you will also come across sequences concept in matrix spaces. In that also we have convergent sequence, divergent sequence concepts, etc. There also we have to prove those results on the same line. Very slight difference is there. What we are doing here, mod of Sn minus L represent distance between Sn and L in matrix space. Distance between two numbers, say x and y is represented by d of xy. And in images, say if we have some function f from xd to y row matrix space, then distance between image will become rho of fx fa. And then we'll only take definition of limit continuity in terms of that distance function. So modulus sign just get replaced by distance function d rho etc in matrix spaces. This is slight changes, and on parallel line will prove results in matrix spaces. There is not too much difference. So we have to prove this. So for uniqueness, we'll assume that suppose there is some sequence which has two limits, and then we'll try to prove that both limits are equal. Okay, for uniqueness we'll assume that there are two things and we'll prove that both things are same. So let Sn, n is equal to 1 to infinity, be convergent real sequence. Suppose limit n tends to infinity of Sn is equal to L. What is your aim? Your aim is L is unique. For this, suppose limit of Sn is equal to if limit of Sn is equal to m, then to show L is equal to m. This is our aim. Okay. On contrary, if L is not equal to M, then if I take epsilon is equal to mod of L minus M by 4 greater than 0. If L not equal to M, then distance between L and M is positive. Mod of L minus M by 4 is greater than 0. Why I have taken 4, I will explain it later on. What is the purpose of taking 4 there? If you don't take 4 here, then laterally you have to make some adjustment and you have to adjust that denominator there. From 1 and 2, for epsilon greater than 0, for any epsilon greater than 0 means for this epsilon greater than 0 also, there exist positive integers n1, n2 such that mod of Sn minus L less than epsilon for any n greater equal n1 and mod of Sn minus M less than epsilon for any n greater equal n2. Suppose this n1 is 100, n2 is 150. Mod of Sn minus L is same on this side. So this statement is true for n greater equal 100 and this is great true for n greater equal 150. So both statements are true simultaneously for n greater equal 150. So if I choose 150 among 100 and 150, then both of them remains true. So if I choose n not to be maximum of n1 and n2, both of these statements hold simultaneously. This implies mod of Sn minus L comma mod of Sn minus M, both are less than epsilon for any n greater equal n naught is equal to maximum of n1 n2. Okay, for this will give 3. Now mod of L minus M, I have to obtain contradiction. I proved that L not equal to M, then I have to obtain some contradiction for distance between L and M again. So I am taking mod L minus M and I have to relate this via terms of the given sequence because I have these expressions. So what we'll do here, we'll insert Sn, means we'll subtract and add Sn there. So this is equal to mod of L minus Sn plus Sn minus M by triangle inequality of real numbers. This is less equal mod of L minus Sn plus mod of Sn minus M. This is less than L minus Sn is same as mod of L minus Sn is same as mod of Sn minus L. So this is epsilon plus epsilon is equal to 2 epsilon for any n greater equal n naught from 3. Therefore, mod of L minus M is less than 2 times, but what is epsilon? Mod of L minus M by 4. This implies mod of L minus M is less than mod of L minus M by 2. This is impossible. Given positive number cannot be less than half of it. Therefore, our assumption is wrong. Therefore, L must be equal to M. Thus, the result is proved. So, today we have discuss convergent sequence, divergent sequences, and if the given sequence is convergent, then it has unique limit. So with this discussion, today we'll stop here. Goodbye.